And the integrity of the Victoria Police Force is tonight under question. The state's top cops have announced a major investigation is underway following revelations the force has been infiltrated by outlaw motorcycle gangs for at least a decade. As many as 10 officers are believed to have been corrupted. Mazoe Ford has this report.
These links had been developing over decades.
Once these sorts of organisations get their hooks into anyone, they rarely let go without a fight.
That's the strategy of the OMCGs. Cultivate, compromise and corrupt.
In one corner, those enforcing the law. In the other, those flouting it. But now we learn their worlds collide.
Often these issues are around criminality, often they're around naivety, and often they're around stupidity. But in each case, there is evidence of outlaw motorcycle gangs trying to reach inside Victoria Police.
The force has known of illegal bikie links since 2003, but was concentrating on the high-profile underworld killings and organised crime.
About a decade or so ago, we missed some of this. There were the signs were there, but the organisation wasn't in a position where we had the intelligence or the wherewithal to take action.
Now it does, and at least 10 investigations involving as many officers are underway. A task force has been set up to look for evidence of officers providing gang members with sensitive information. Aspiring cops and new recruits will be under greater scrutiny too, and anyone with even a tenuous link to bikies must declare it.
And they associate in gymnasiums, they associate through interests in motorcycles and the like. Tattoo parlours, that's the source of the relationship building, and they take it from there.
Jeopardising their own safety, compromising investigations and damaging the force's credibility.
It's the reputation of the police force that suffers, and the 99.99% of our members who don't have anything at all to do with it get tarred with the same brush, and that's a concern for everyone.
Especially as officers try to ease the threat of a bikie war between the Bandidos and the Hells Angels.
If this intelligence gets out, people's lives are at risk.
The motto of this police force is delivering a safer Victoria, but rarely has its thin blue line been so blurred.
Earlier I spoke to Olivia Monaghan, a police corruption researcher from the University of Melbourne. Olivia, thanks very much for your time. Well, one of your areas of research expertise is looking into the effectiveness of our various anti-corruption bodies. These revelations will surely put those organisations to the test. Just how entrenched is this corruption?
It's hard to tell at the moment without any definitive evidence. I think what you need to rephrase the issue, however, is the risk that can happen and the speed at which corruption can become contagious within a police force. If you look at New South Wales, it spread quite quickly over a couple of decades, and I think we've seen that happen here. It started off with the gangland issue, and now we've seen it come in with the bikies have kind of filled that void. So you do need to look at tough reforms in the police force and also a strong and quick response from the Victorian Police.
So in practical terms then, does this breach mean we have a situation where you've got some of the most highly sensitive, highly confidential information now in the hands of some of Australia's most dangerous criminals?
Yes, it does. When you have that level of access, certainly there is that risk. So what the Victorian Police will need to do is look at how they can minimise the contact between vice institutions or organised criminals such as the bikies and members of their police force.
So the flow-on effect of that then must be the potential to compromise the safety not just of police informants but also the safety of undercover officers.
There is that possibility, but I don't think that that's the main possibility we should focus on. I think we should focus on improving future practices within the Victorian Police.
Even the possibility, though, of course, is hugely alarming. Is there a risk, too, that this could jeopardise hearings, potential trials within the Victorian justice system?
Potentially, yes.
Olivia, we also heard today that serving officers have been using performance-enhancing drugs. Often they have been supplied by the bikies themselves. Is there an argument to restricting the actual physical access that some of these officers have with the bikies?
Definitely. I think that's one way in which the Victorian Police could really effectively institute some reform, is to minimise this access. I mean, some stories came out today of police officers on their off-duty behaviour, going to or frequenting strip clubs in the city which have links to the bikie gangs. And again, this just shows how police officers can have that access to corrupt channels or illicit channels. So you do need to minimise those and set in practice some systems and plays in which that risk is changed or lessened.
Police Chief Ken Lay has promised the gloves are off now, but we know, of course, that corruption can be extraordinarily difficult to overcome in the short term. How long will it take to weed these officers out?
It's impossible to say. The New South Wales case there, they had a Royal Commission and that took 7 years. In Hong Kong, their reforms took 6. So it is impossible, really. It depends on each case, unfortunately. But hopefully we'll see a speedy resolution.
Olivia Monaghan, thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.